Welcome. Menschenit Publishing is excited to announce the long-awaited publishing of the Jews of Biržai, The Last Sabbath. We are lucky to have the author Michael Bean, who will walk us through a summary of the book. I will be back to announce some exciting pre-order and exclusive offers only from Menschenit. But now, I am pleased to introduce to you Michael Bean, the author of the Jews of Biržai, The Last Sabbath.
Thank you for expressing interest in the Jews of Biržai and watching this video. If you haven't already watched the book trailer, it is available on the Menschenit.com homepage and on YouTube. Just search for the book title for viewing. It's only a minute and a half, and it contains additional information and pictures about the book. In the next 20 minutes or so, I will cover my origin story, how I came to learn that I am a son of Biržai, which serendipitously led me to write this book, an overview of the book, the new website, and how to pre-order exclusive purchasing options and gain access to additional resources and gain access to the database. While sitting in my grandmother's kitchen, who we called Mom, in 1994, my wife, Teresa, and I were just married, and she was interested in learning about the family. After many interesting conversations with tea and cookies, my mom provided us with a 100-year-old pile of Yiddish documents from her junk drawer in her kitchen. We gladly accepted them initially, doing absolutely nothing, except we transferred them to our junk drawer. About 10 years later, when my parents were moving, we discovered old black and white family photos, many without names. Now, with old Yiddish documents and pictures, the whole Megillah, or the long involved story, was underway. The term genealogical gold didn't exist back in 1994 for us, but it soon would when we made discovery of my Biržai roots. Thanks to Google Translate, we were able to translate one Cyrillic letter at a time on the postmark from a 1905 postcard that my mom had given to us, pointing us to Biržai, Lithuania. Nobody in the family ever even knew about our Lithuanian roots, let alone the town of Biržai. Hence, the term genealogical gold, which opened many unlocked doors of our family research. And then, the shocking discovery was made of the August 8, 1941 massacre that killed 2,400 souls, including my aunts, uncles, and dozens of my cousins. Sadly, some of your family may have also been killed too. In June of 2019, a tour of over 40 people from the U.S., United Kingdom, Israel, South Africa, all with connections to Biržai, came for a dedication of a memorial at the Ostrava Grove where the Jews of Biržai were murdered. This fed my desire to both tell the story of the Jews of Biržai and for me to eulogize the 2,400 Jewish souls who perished. This book memorializes not only the town, but also the people who perished in June of 1941. My intent is to restore their honor and recover stories of our brothers and sisters of both the righteous Lithuanians and the Jews of Biržai. This book provides a legacy of the shtetl, memorializes the 2,400 who died on August 8, 1941, and commemorates the millions of victims who were lost in the Holocaust. Now we're going to focus on the families. The Jews of Biržai is about families. The main family is the Maggids. My Chayat roots have ties to the Maggid family. Burl David Maggid wrote a memoir, What I Have to Tell, Pages from a Life, that was published in Yiddish back in 1992. I had his memoir translated over a 2.5-year period, and it provided many stories, names, and details about life in Biržai that I was able to include in the book. The Maggid family and the Bass family were very close. Relatives from the Bass, Kaplan, and Shochat families provided additional stories and pictures of the relationship between these two families. My goal of the book was to include as many names as possible, both survivors and of the murdered, to personalize and memorialize as many people as possible. I wanted to remove the anonymity of a nondescript number. These were real people with real names, lives, families, faces, stories, and hopes and dreams. The book is divided into three parts, or acts. Part one is called A 20-Year Simmer. This includes stories of life in the interwar period in this Eastern European shtetl. This covers the period after World War I and leading up to World War II. It discusses world events while focusing on the struggles, hopes, and dreams of Biržai Jews. Part 2, Changing Landlords. This covers a one-year period between the Russian occupation in June of 1940 and the German invasion in June of 1941. And Part 3, The Null Hypothesis. This covers a three-month time window between the start of Operation Barbarossa in June of 1941 and the massacre in August of 1941. Next, I will walk you through some highlights of each of these three parts. Part 1, A 20-Year Simmer. The First World War has ended. There's political unrest and difficult times finding jobs across the region. In Biržai, families were returning from being excommunicated to Kazan, Russia, and were returning home. You will meet the Magid family, the Bass family, and the Bader family, specifically Sonia. The Jewish population in Biržai swelled to about 1,200. You will learn about the great religious and education life in Biržai, relationships, dating, and marriage, and one of the primary business opportunities was conducted at the marketplace. Some events in Biržai. Some families were returning, including my family, who went to America and returned back to Biržai in 1926. Some were leaving. Sam Ferber writing home to his family in South Africa, asking for a way to get out. And some left. Katsumana Magid, who migrated to South Africa in 1929. The Jewish population has grown to almost 5,000 in 1935, almost doubling since the turn of the century. What's shown is a map of the Biržai shtetl and Jewish families that resided there in that time period. Also, some Jewish students in Biržai around that time. What is going on in the world outside of Biržai at the time? A few key world events. The Germans people elected Nazis to political power in 1932. The Nazis established the Nuremberg Laws in 1935. Germany and Russia signed a non-aggressive pact in 1939, the Molotov-Ribbentrop Act. Shortly after that, Germany invaded Poland, and with the event of that, World War II was underway. Even with all these things happening in Europe, things didn't change that much yet for the Jews of Biržai. Part 2, Changing Landlords. This part is signaled by three memorable events. First, Germany continues its aggression, invading multiple countries in Western Europe. Second, Hitler arrives in Paris in June of 1940. And third, which has big impact for the Jews of Biržai, Russian troops enter Biržai in June of 1940. The Jews of Biržai were still glad it was not the Germans or the Nazis. The Jews were happier with the Russians because they were not the Nazis. However, let us remember, the lesser of two evils is still evil. In this time period, you're going to meet Matul Levitan and his family and learn about his story. You're going to meet Regina Botvinate and her righteous family. You're going to meet the Friedlander siblings who fought in the Russian army against the Nazis. And Matul Kerbel, a Jew who worked for the Russian administration and made life very difficult for the Jews of Biržai. Over a two-day period in June of 1941, specifically June 14th and 15th, the Russians suddenly and unexpectedly deported select Jews and Lithuanians from Biržai to Russia. A lot of them to, unfortunately, Siberia. A list of the 29 Jews that were deported from Biržai is depicted as well, of the multiple 15,000 across the Baltics. This book will reveal and unravel this chaotic event. This spontaneous deportation was a clear signal that things are now getting much more difficult for the Jews of Biržai. Only 2 weeks after the surprise Russian deportations, Germany launched a surprise attack of Russia, starting Operation Barbarossa on June 22, 1941. This triggered large-scale attempts for the Jews of Biržai to flee towards Russia. The Germans arrived in Biržai on June 26, 1941. The mobile killing units, Einsatzgruppen, following behind the invading troops and began the mass execution of Jews across Eastern Europe. These events marked the end of part two and the beginning of a horrendous chapter for the Jews of Biržai. Part three, the null hypothesis. Basically states, is there any difference when examining two groups? Would the fate of the Jews have been better if they stayed or left? Location, sadly, had no effect on fate. Prominent Jews like Dr. Avram Levin, pictured, and Rabbi Yehuda Bernstein were targeted and killed between June and August 1941. The Nazis purposely killed prominent people in towns to keep resistance to a minimum. It had been reported that there were 30 Jews of Biržai killed between June and August 1941, and what's shown in that chart are 17 of the 30 who were buried in a Jewish cemetery. Life has become very stressful, and people are trying to leave and head out of Biržai. Naftali Magid headed to Klaipeda to escape, and he was there when the Germans annexed that region of Lithuania. Sonia Bader heads south, back to Kiwanis, to look for help for her family. And multiple Jews, including the Friedlanders, join the Russian army, Bass and Magid family members, and their neighbors scrambling to escape amid the chaos. Murder, rapes, beatings, and atrocities were occurring during this period of time while the Nazis occupied Biržai. What's shown is a rare photo of Jews being escorted by Lithuanian collaborators in Biržai in July of 1941. In the book, there is a link to this picture. Jews were forced to wear yellow stars, adhere to new rules, and were brutalized while performing forced labor. A ghetto was formed, depicted by the red lines on July 28, 1941. You will hear about what life was like inside and outside of the ghetto during this time frame. On August 5, 1941, all the Jews of Biržai were moved from the ghetto to the Hasidic synagogue. They were all packed into one synagogue for 3 days, with continued atrocities and lies being told to them. And then on August 8, 1941, the Jews of Biržai were marched 3 kilometers to the Ostrava Grove and massacred, all in one day. Amazingly, though, there were a few survivors. The Jews of Biržai, children, women, and men. ...2,400 were massacred on August 8, 1941. The monuments, and now this book, helps to memorialize their lives. So what's happening? What happened to the Bass family, the Ferber family, the Magid family, Mata Levitan, Sam Ferber? Who lives? Who dies? Among these names and a long list of others revealed in the book, You will need to read the Jews of Biržai to find out who lives and who dies. Now, I'm going to turn it back over to Menschenit, who will tell you about the exciting pre-order and exclusive offers only available from Menschenit.com.
Menschenit has launched a new website in support of the book, The Jews of Biržai, The Last Sabbath. Let me now tell you two things about the website. First, the site contains information about the author, The Jews of Biržai, and how to contact and subscribe to the newsletter. Secondly, the website also contains additional resources from The Jews of Biržai, some free and some requiring a subscription. Let me mention three of these things. First, the Biržai database, 1860 to 1941, lists anyone who was born after 1860 and through 1941 who has ties to Biržai. Some examples include birth, death, marriage, owned property, and other things. There are currently 7,000 names in the database, a great tool for conducting your genealogy research. Be sure to view the free preview on the website. Second, once you get your book, look for Table 3. It is a summary of the 650 last names with ties to Biržai. Some of you will see your family listed there in this free list. Lastly, additional tables in the book are also available and searchable on the website for free. They include deportees to Russia, June 1941, Jewish families in the shtetl, and a list of names on the memorial wall in Biržai. In summary, all you need to remember is to go to Menschenit.com website. Click the resource tab and view this valuable information. Now for information about the pre-orders. Menschenit is now offering pre-order and exclusive deals. There are two offerings for paperback and two offerings for hardback. The books are bundled with either an ebook and/or access to the database, the same 7,000-person database that I previously mentioned. First, a signed paperback with an ebook. Second, a signed paperback with a 6-month subscription to the database. Third, a signed hardback option with an ebook. And lastly, a hardback option with a lifetime subscription to the database. Now, let's quickly discuss the pricing. Let me start with the two paperback pre-order specials. A signed paperback plus free ebook can be purchased for a discounted price of $24. Or a signed paperback plus a 6-month subscription to the database can be purchased for a discounted price of $28. Tax and shipping and handling is extra. All pre-orders must be made on Menschenit.com. United States residents can order online. All others or anyone needing help can send an email to info@menschenit.com to make arrangements. Remember to go to Menschenit.com website, then click the Books tab, and then click the Read More button to purchase these special offers. Now let's talk about the two hardback pre-order specials. First, a signed hardback plus free ebook can be purchased for a discounted price of $36. Second, a signed hardback plus lifetime subscription to the database can be purchased for $48. Again, there are currently 7,000 names in the database. Tax and shipping and handling is extra. Again, all pre-orders must be made on Menschenit.com. United States residents can order online. All others, or anyone needing help, can send an email to info@menschenit.com to make arrangements. And one more time, go to Menschenit.com website, then click the Books tab, then click on the pink Read More button to purchase these special offers. Thank you for listening. The Jews of Biržai, The Last Sabbath was published in December of 2021. Exclusive deals, signed copies, bundled with an ebook or a subscription, and hardbacks are only available directly through the publisher, Menschenit.com, and are available now. You will be able to purchase paperback and ebook via online sellers, such as Amazon and Barnes & Noble, for example, in January of 2022. However, special pricing, bundles, and hardbacks are exclusively through MentionIt.com. Purchasing of pre-orders from outside the United States must be made via email to info@MentionIt.com. We hope you enjoy the book. We look forward to your reactions, comments, and reviews. Thank you.